Hey there, and welcome to this tutorial on Microsoft Teams. Today, we're going to be going over how to block a number, as well as how to change your status and notification preferences. In addition to these video tutorials, we also have in-depth tutorials on our website if you want to check those out. First, let's go over blocking. Making sure Microsoft Teams is open, select the Calls icon to view your recent calls. When you hover over a number, as shown, you'll see a More Options menu show up. That's those three little dots. Click the three dots and select Block. Now the number will have a blocked indicator next to it. If you made a mistake or would like to unblock, just click those three little dots again and click Unblock. To review all your blocked callers, click the three dots in the top right corner of the app and from there click Settings, which has a gear icon next to it. From the Settings pop-up menu, click Privacy and then click Edit Blocked Contacts. From there, you can review or unblock all numbers you have blocked. Let's say that you don't need to block a caller, but you'd like to stop notifications from appearing when you're busy. There's a couple ways to do this. First, let's look at changing your status. Click your profile photo in the top right corner of the app. Select your current status, located right below your name and email, and a drop-down menu will appear with different status options. Available shows when you're currently active in Teams without anything in your calendar. If Teams is closed or your computer goes to sleep, this status will change to Away. Busy is when you need to focus on something. Teams will automatically change your status to busy if you're in a meeting or a call. Importantly, notifications will show up even if your status is set to busy. Be right back, appear away, and appear offline are all settings you set manually which are meant to indicate you're away for the time being. You will still receive notifications if your status is set to any of these. Do not disturb is about the same as busy, but differs in that you will not receive notifications while your status is set to it. In this mode, only notifications from priority contacts and emergency messages will display. Next to your status, there is a Set Status Message option. If you'd like to attach a message to your status, you can input text and choose how long you want it to display. Selecting a status such as Do Not Disturb does not turn off automatically unless you select a duration, which you can see below the status options. Click that duration button and set a time that works for you. As mentioned earlier, when in Do Not Disturb mode, you will not receive notifications other than priority contacts. If you'd like to edit your priority contacts list, go to Settings, Privacy, and then click the Manage Priority Access button. It's right above the Edit Blocked Contacts button. Use the search bar to find users to add, or click the X next to their name to delete them from your list. Now let's talk about changing your notification preferences more broadly. Still in the Settings window, click Notifications. This is right below the Privacy tab. You'll see several different options. Email notifications send you an email with a summary of missed or unread messages. You can change the time intervals at which you were sent these, or you can turn them off. From the Appearance and Sound menu, you can select what type of notification sound you want to hear, whether you'd like a notification sound, and whether you want a preview of the notification's text content. From the Teams and Channels menu, you can select what notifications you'll see from your Teams and Channels. All activity means you will be notified of any activity in the channels you're in, and mentions and replies means you will only be notified when someone mentions you directly or replies to you. Selecting Custom allows you to choose if and where notifications about your Teams and Channels show up. You can select for notifications to appear in your banner notifications, activity feed, both, or neither. The Chat tab allows you to choose how you'd like to be notified regarding chat messages, including direct mentions, messages, and reactions to messages. The Meetings and Calls tab lets you customize your preferences for notifications while you're in a meeting. You can toggle them on or off, as well as your notification preferences for when a meeting starts. You can also change your notification settings for the meeting chat. The People tab allows you to follow others' status and be notified when they appear available or offline. Finally, the Other tab allows you to get notifications if others in your contacts start using Teams. Thanks for watching.